I told this story in a thread I posted yesterday, but I'll post it again. Before I post my personal story, I need to fill you in on the legend. So strap yourselves in, X, this is the legend of the Lost Lights. Chapter 1. Part 1, The Mountain. It all starts off in the mid-1800s. An expeditionary force of 25 men go exploring in the mountain ranges of BC, looking for suitable places to start a mine. They hike up a mountain and camp there for the night. That night, when one of them gets up to go relieve their bowels, and trips and hurts their leg in the dark. In the morning it is decided that 12 men will help the injured man down the mountain and back to civilization, while the rest of them, 12, continue on ahead. So the group splits up. They hiked until the evening. One of the men noticed it had gotten considerably colder. It then started to snow slightly only minutes later. He expressed his concern that they might get snowed over in the night. The others laughed it off. They joked and teased about him being scared. Part 2, The Storm. As the evening turned into twilight, it got colder and colder, the snow got heavier and heavier. They had gone a ways up the mountain, so it was a difficult and deadly situation if the storm got worse. The snow showed signs of not letting up. In fact, it was certain to become a monstrous storm. The 12 men faced a tough situation. They needed to get back down the mountain, or else they would freeze to death. They left their tents and took what was needed. They started back down the mountain in the raging storm. They each lit their oil lamps as they headed down. Because of the blizzard that ensued, they could hardly see the light of the man in front of them. The man who had noted the snow earlier, Jacob Wright, had lost sight of the lanterns. In fact, all of them seemed to have. They walked around aimlessly on the mountain, calling out, trying to find each other. Just when it couldn't get any worse, the wind became even stronger. Jacob knew he had to get down the mountain or he would die there. He stopped trying to find the others and went with the slope, slowly making his way down. He managed to get down the slope and to the base. Part 3, The Lights. Jacob ran to find the 13 men that were headed back to get help in rescuing his comrades. But he could not go on any further. The storm had spread to the bottom and across the valley. He found a nearby cave where he would spend the night. As the night progressed, he watched the lights of his fellow expeditionaries wander endlessly across the mountain in the hellish snowstorm. Throughout the night he watched them. The first light went out and disappeared at around midnight. Others followed in the next hours. One by one, they extinguished. Jacob hoped, prayed, that at least one light would last the night. The last one went out 3 hours from the first. All hope was lost in the morning. When the storm cleared, Jacob headed further into the valley to find the 13 men that had gone back earlier yesterday. When he found them, there was only 2 left alive. The rest had died in the storm that swept down from the mountain and into the valley. The men and Jacob exchanged stories. The men told Jacob that they had seen the wandering lights up on the mountainside. The 2 men only found out in the morning that 11 men had died in the night from the cold. Part 4, The Dead. 3 weeks later, an expeditionary force of 20 men, including Jacob, returned to recover anything of those who had died in the storm. They found the remains of the 11 men in the valley easily enough. They recovered their personal effects and what little bone they could find to bring back to their families. There was not much left of them from the wildlife picking at them. The bodies of the men who died up on the mountain, however, they found none, no sign of them. Gone without a trace, they searched until dusk. Then, the air got colder, light snow began to fall down. Just like on the night Jacob's comrades met their end. They hightailed it down the mountain and into the valley. They made it into the middle of the valley and made camp for the night. Then storm came down from the mountain and into the valley just like last time. Just like the night when Jacob lost his comrades. It got colder and colder in the valley as the storm continued to battle down from the mountain. Part 5, The Lost. That night, Jacob and the men saw something that they could not quite believe. They saw lights, wandering upon the blizzarding mountainside. They watched from their individual tents throughout the night, as one by one the wandering lights went out. Jacob knew that it must be the spirits of his friends. Jacob wondered why he only saw 10 lights when it was 11 of his friends that disappeared up on the mountainside. Had one survived? Could one of his friends still be alive? Somewhere, lost out there in the wilderness? Where was the lost light up on the high? Answers came in the morning, answers of where the lost light went. When Jacob awoke in the morning, the storm had cleared. Jacob and the 9 other men stepped out of their tents. 9 other men, 10 men had died from the cold that night. They must have died one by one in the night, succumbing to the cold. One by one, the 10 men's lives, snuffed out by the cold. Snuffed out like the 10 lights up on the mountainside. Chapter 2, Part 1. And now, X, it is time to share my personal experience with the lost lights. Be me, 35. Have 3 teenage boys. Decide to go hiking with my sons, my buddy, and his 2 sons. We drive out to the edge of the wilderness at 4 a.m., park the car and start hiking at 4:30. We hike all day, only stopping at noon shortly for a quick lunch. We are walking at a decent pace. We reach the middle of a valley in the evening. We decide to camp there for the night. We ate a quick dinner and everyone went to sleep pretty quick after that from being tired from the hiking. Everyone went to bed but me. I decided to stay up and drink some beers and chillax in a fold-up chair I brought. I sat there staring at the sun that just set behind the mountain range. It got pretty cold after the sunset. Put on my jacket then, the fireflies came out. They danced slowly across the shape of the mountain. These fireflies were pretty weird. They didn't leave the shape of the mountain, and they didn't flash like normal fireflies. Then it hits me. Publish it, oh fuck.jpg. Immediately get the fuck up and wake everyone. Part 2. Tell them to pack their shit, and we gotta move now. My buddy asks, what's wrong? What happened? Me, I saw them. Buddy, saw what? Me, the lost lights. Buddy looks over my shoulder and sees the lights on the mountainside. He then notices how cold it has gotten. Buddy rushes to pack everything up with the kids. We hike back as fast as we can. The boys had overheard what me and my buddy were saying. Dad, what is the lost lights? Why are we leaving right now? Can't we leave in the morning? No, I said, and I proceeded to tell them the story of the lost lights while hiking back. At around 2:30 a.m. we managed to get back to the car, and we hightailed it out of there. I drop my buddy off, and me and my kids go home. I woke up at noon. Found out from the weather station there was a huge snowstorm that swept the valley we were in last night. Here comes the really scary part, X. I saw 7 lights up on the mountainside. There were 7 of us on the trip. And that, X, is my experience with the lost lights.